Okay, in this video, we're gonna set up the Queenspace Hyper 50mm disc brake tubeless. This is my first setup ever, my first tubeless setup ever. We'll see how hard or easy it is to set them up tubeless for a beginner. There are many videos online that you can check of how to set up tubeless in general, but I wanted to see how hard it is to install specifically the Continental 5000. These are 28s, which are really hard to find nowadays, by the way, on the Hyper wheel set. So I'll give it a shot. And first thing I want to do is, I want to make sure I'm putting it on the right rotational direction on the wheel. So we'll check the rotational direction. All right, it goes this way, good. So we want to install them this way, and I want the logo, the Continental logo, to be directly on top of the valve. So we're going to start with the valve here. Okay, now we want to make sure that the tire, the beads are sitting inside the center of the rim itself. We'll make our life a little bit easier. Okay. Almost there. Massaging the tire, so to speak. That's it. It's in. What I want to do next is to see if I can pump the tires without using the chamber on that Topeak pump. So we're just gonna pump it regular. We'll see if I can seat the bead on the tire itself, on the rim itself. Pressure building up already. We are at 80 already. All right, I got to 110. I think that the tire is basically seating right now on the bead itself. Looks okay. It didn't make the sound of the clicking of engaging and locking into the wheel, but I believe it is. So let's lower the pressure just a little. Back to about 80. All right. And that's it, that's how easy it was. All right, so while I'm staring at the wheel in amazement of how easy it was to mount the tires and seat the bead, I did add the sealant to the front wheel first. But unfortunately, with the camera angle, I didn't get it on video that well. So we're gonna move to the rear wheel, and I did get the sealant application much better over there. So let's move to the rear wheel. This is so easy, it's just ridiculous. I've seen so many horror videos online of mounting tubeless on tubeless wheels. This is just ridiculous easy. So easy. All right, pump it like we are with a regular. As for the sealant, I chose to go with the Orange Endurance. Everybody recommended it online, my teammates, my mechanic. I'm shaking it well before applying. And here I'm taking off the valve cord in order to be able to apply the sealant into the tire. And after reading a lot of recommendations online, I chose to go with 50 mil per tire. You want to position the valve core at the 7 o'clock position. So after installing the valve core back with the sealant inside the tire, since the bead is already seated, all you have to do technically is just to pump air back into the tire. After you're done with the application and there's some pressure in the tire, it's very important to shake it and make sure that the sealant is coating the tire from the inside throughout. That's how easy it was to set the two wheels tubeless. It's done. I'm finished with the whole setup. All I have to do right now is to put the cassette back on from my old wheels and the disc brake itself, and I am ready to go. You know what? Before that, let's see the weight of the wheels, the entire wheels with the tires and the sealant in them. We'll see what the whole system weighs like that, without the disc so far and without the cassette itself. So let's check the weight of the wheel set with the tires mounted and the sealant inside. Starts with the front wheel, and it is 1,065 grams for the front wheel. Okay, and the rear wheel didn't want to stay on the scale, so I put a little tape there just to make sure it stays, and it is now 0 grams, so the rear wheel is 1189 grams. And after installation of the tire before the first ride, it measured just above 28 millimeter, which is almost flush with the width of the rim at 26 millimeter. So to sum up my tubeless installation, my first tubeless installation on the Hyper wheels, this was really easy, at least from my experience. So chapeau to Winspace for making wheels that sitting just exactly right with the Continental 5000s. It was really easy to install, so I was really happy. I'll say that probably the whole process took me about 40 minutes, maybe a little longer than that, with filming and everything else. I believe that if I have to do it all over again, it will probably take me much less than this. It is just so easy. I'll say probably anywhere between 5 to 10 minutes a tire. That's it for the first installation. If I have to ever change it, take it off and change the tires or move it to different wheels, that might be a different story. Anyhow, this was my experience only this one time, so I hope next times will be as easy as well. All I have to say that hopefully, you know, from now on, unless anything, you know, drastic happened to the tire and I have like a big gouge, I'm not gonna have to replace it or touch it until the end of its lifespan, which could be like about a year from now. All I have to do is to tap up some more sealant every few months, because the sealant does tend to dry out just a little bit, just to make sure I have some fresh sealant at all times. And that's it. So hopefully in a few months time, after riding them outdoors and maybe even racing them, I release my third part, which will be my full review on the wheel set. So stay tuned, guys.